This is one exercise you should do every time you work out. Segment number four of the Body Electric video workout exercises the lower body, and we're going to begin with the outer thigh exercise. Donna? As in all exercises, form is so important. You want to have a straight line from the underarm to the hip, so that's right, bring the elbow in and lift. Now you want to have your hips stacked one on top of the other, and you can go ahead and reach that arm forward to help you accomplish this. In addition, the feet should be in line with the hips, kind of a straight line from the feet to the hips. And go ahead and lift the leg and you're ready to work the outer thighs. As we begin the outer thigh exercise, I can't emphasize enough how important it is to understand your particular fitness level. Work at your own pace with the understanding that you'll do a little more each time and you'll have a success that way. So let's begin the exercise in the correct position. For those of you that are beginners, you might want to do it as Jane mode with your head totally on the floor. For the rest of you that are a little more accomplished, you'll do it with the ribcage lifted. Okay, let's reach forward with the top arm. Make sure their hips are one on top of the other and lift and press. Now this is a two-sided movement. In other words, you lift and you press. There's constant energy. Shoulders down, neck long. I want you to constantly evaluate your body head to toe. Make sure you know that you're doing everything correctly. Take some concentration. Abdomen in. Get ready to change for two. And lift. And down. Kind of wiggle your toes. Relax your feet a little. You should be feeling this right at the top of the thigh. Right in the outer thigh, kind of as it connects to the gluteal muscle. Go ahead and put some weight on that front arm. Make sure that your hips are stacked one over the other. And look at your leg and see that your knee and your foot are lifting at the same level. That your knee is not lifting higher than your foot. And you're constantly checking to see that your outer thigh is facing up, facing the ceiling. Get ready to change and pulse it up, up, lift, and lift. If at any time you need to lie down totally, by all means do that. You don't want to be distracted from the area that you're really working. So if you feel fatigued in the neck and shoulders, go ahead and take care of yourself. Personalize the workout. This is a very small movement. Now we're going to all lie down and push and pull. As you extend the leg, you don't want to lock the knee. Now I'm going to rest my head on my hand so I can talk to you a little more easily, but I would like you to have your head on your arm. So you have a straight line from your head to your tailbone. Push and pull. Push. Check your hips. Make sure they're one on top of the other. Push and pull. You don't have to have the leg very high. We're working about hip high. Get ready to change. Okay, now I'd like you to bring your knees together, lift your feet, and continue working the knees, open and close, open and close. If at any time you feel very fatigued and you need to take a stretch, go ahead and stretch, and then start again if you're able. Abdomen in tight. Even in this position, we're supporting our back. Feel the weight of your body against the floor. Everything is active. There's nothing passive going on here. You're aware of all body parts, and every part of your body is active, doing its share. Keep it going. Open and close. Push and push. How are we feeling, gang? Oh, we're feeling great. That sounds like Tony the Tiger. Remember Tony the Tiger? Place the feet down and lift. Push and lift. You know, these exercises do require some repetition, and unless you feel that fatigue, well, you're just kind of wasting your time. We want to make our time together very effective. Get the most out of it. Okay, good job. Now we've got to stretch the muscle. It's very important. You want to get your muscle back to its resting length. So even in the stretch, I want you to keep the shoulders and hips facing the same direction and kind of sit into that working hip and feel the muscle lengthen. You ready to do the other leg? I know, I can't wait. I'm excited. Let's do it. Get the form absolutely correct. And lift. And bend. Your feet should be in line with your hips. Ribcage lifted. Abdomen in, shoulders down. Make the movement elegant. Make it beautiful. Shoulders down. Kind of lift up and out of it. Now for two, hold it and lift and press. Lift and press. Remember, energy. And press. Working the outer thigh, the hips one on top of the other. We want to be aware of keeping the back as straight as possible. Pump it up, up, and up. This is a very small movement. Very small lift. Gives us an opportunity to keep the muscle contracted. Up. If you're getting fatigued, see if you can work into it a little. As soon as the form goes, you know it's time to take a stretch. Okay, let's take the body totally down. And push and pull. Push and pull. Everybody, your head is down on your arm. Push and pull. Remember, in the extended position, you don't want to lock your knee. You want to keep it just slightly relaxed. You never want to overuse the joints to work the muscles. You never want to sacrifice one body part for another. You want to have a safe, effective workout. Okay, let's bring the leg down totally. Lift the feet. Open and close. You should be feeling this right in the outer thigh, right where you want to feel, right where you need to feel it. Tone up those muscles, give the leg a sleek appearance. Open and close, check your form, head to toe, evaluate. So what do you give yourself, an A plus? I hope so. Open and close. Open and close. Make that muscle work. Okay, let's bring the feet down and continue. Very controlled, very disciplined, very effective. Do a little more. Press and lift. Come on, energy. Let's just hold it up and finish this leg with a pulse. Small movement. Challenge yourself. Make it work. And if you've had to stop and take a stretch, well, hopefully you've joined us again and you're increasing your resistance, your ability, your endurance, I should say, your ability to endure the exercise. Okay, let's bring the leg down and sit up and take a stretch. You earned it.
These exercises will tone and contour your muscles, but to reduce body fat, you'll need aerobic exercises and attention to diet.
Now that we've worked the outer thighs, we're going to give equal time to the inner thighs. Jules, on your back, please. It's very important when you do this exercise that the feet be over the hips, that the legs are at a right angle to the body. The knees slightly relaxed. And for those of you that are beginners, go ahead and put your hands under your hips and begin the exercise. Now that we've worked the outer thighs, it's important that we work the inner thighs. We want to have balanced muscles to give the leg a shape we look. So, let's lie on the floor. Placing the hands under the hips. And let's have our legs up at a right angle to the body. So your feet are basically over your hips. Abdomen pressed in. Both shoulders on the floor. Here we go. Out and in. You don't have to open the legs too far. We want to keep the control going. Use no momentum. and certainly not stress our hip area. Keep the knees just somewhat relaxed. You can kind of relax your toes a little. Put all the energy into working the inner thighs. Pull it in. Pull it in. Bring it down, the knees together, the knees apart, and extend, and in. So the knees are together, apart, extend, and pull. Check your abdomen, make sure that it's pressed against your back, that your lower back is pressed against the floor. As we did in the beginning, open and close. Open and close. Control the movement. That confusion. Remember how you love and say you can't take it without me. Press the shoulders against the floor. Now cross the knee. Open and cross it all the way over. Use the inner thigh. You're on the cross it. Get ready to hold for three.
Break away.
Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Pull it together. Now don't dance the leg too much. I don't want you to dance. I want you to think of a more a hold. Continue. 3, 2, 1. Pull it in. Now, for some of you that are a little less advanced, you might want to do the exercise with the knees bent. But let's all do it that way right now. Bend the knees, pull it in. Those of you that are less advanced and find the exercise a little bit awkward might want to do the entire exercise in this position with the knees bent. Sometimes it's a little more easily accomplished, and we're still getting a great workout for the inner thighs. Continue, push and pull. Create resistance within your body. Think about the air being thick, so you have to push against it. You know, if you were doing this exercise, say, underwater, how you have to push against the water? That's the way I want you to feel. Think inner thighs. All the energy is directed to the inner thighs. Abdomen in. Evaluate your body head to toe. Well, it does take some repetition to get the muscle fatigued, to get it tired. And as you do the repetition, if your legs feel a little shaky, see if you can work into it. Get ready to change in just a moment. If you need to take a break, you need to take a stretch, do what's right for you. Change, up, down, out, and extend. Remember that even if you have to stop and take a stretch, you've had a success, and I want you to recognize that for yourself, because in doing the workout, in doing any exercise, we have little successes all along the way. And we have to feel good about that, that we've done a little more, we've accomplished a little more than we had in our previous workout, and that will happen. Abdomen, shoulders to the floor, the neck relaxed. A few more. Working the inner thighs. Last time, bring the legs down. Support yourself as you sit up. And we're going to stretch the muscle by extending one leg. You can feel the stretch in the extended leg. Let's place our hands on the floor for support. And stretch the other leg. And good job. Wouldn't you rather have your body shape defined by muscle rather than fat? Well, we're on our way. Continuing with the exercises for the lower body, we're going to work the hamstring, the back of the leg. Vanessa. It's particularly important that you bring the knee directly under the hip when doing this exercise. And you want to lift your body, lift your abdomen so that your back is supported, so you have a straight line from the head to the tailbone. And go ahead and bring your elbows in under the shoulders. Great. Then you can lift the leg. Begin the exercise. The hamstring exercise is admittedly a difficult one. So So I want you to do it and do it right. Let's get in the beginning position on our elbows and knees. And make sure that your abdomen is lifted. Make sure that your supporting knee is under the hip. And the other leg is extended behind the body. And we're going to push and pull. Push and pull. Now right away, before we go another moment, I want you to look down and see that both hips are facing the floor equally. We don't want to have our working hip lifted. The leg is extending directly behind the body. The elbows are under the shoulders. And I think we've covered about all body parts. The working leg should not be higher than the hip. So we all have to kind of make an adjustment. You know, with exercising any muscle, you have an opportunity continuously to do it better, to be more in touch with your body, more in touch with the exercise. And to the extent that we can do the best we can do at every moment, the opportunity is there. So let's do it. Push and pull. Think about that muscle in your mind's eye getting short and long. How muscle works, that's how it gets strong. Now up for three, and one, two, three, and down. Now that downward motion starts the upward motion. You don't hesitate. You take it right down and right up. Continuous movement. Your knee is kind of making an arc, like the letter C. Keep it going. You don't want to have your foot too close to your hip. Open the leg so that there's a right angle form. The leg forms a right angle. Shoulders down, neck along. Constantly evaluating your body, hip to toe. Change it for two, up for two, and up. Push with the heel and pull. And push. If you're finding that this exercise becomes a little too fatiguing for you, that the form is becoming out of control, then that's your clue to stop and take a stretch. Hold it up and push and point. Heel and toe. So you have an opportunity at any time to personalize the workout to do what's best for you. And remember, the endurance will come, but it's most important that the form be correct so that you don't injure yourself. Make our time together very safe, very effective. Very small range of motion, very small. Working into that fatigue. Change it as we did in the beginning. Push and pull. Again, square it off. Your back is like a tabletop. Your knee is bent hip high. And you're having the time of your life. But you are, right? You guys having the time of your life? You better be. Yeah. Why don't I believe it? Okay, get ready to change. Maybe now you have the time of your life. One, two, three. Oh, yeah, I just had it. And down. That's the fun part. That's what you look forward to when you get that kind of a rush. You know you're working hard. And for two, lift your abdomen. Keep the form correct. And for two, just a few more to the top. Flex and point. Flex. And point. How about one more? Flex and point. Good job. Take a stretch.
Your form is most important. Endurance will follow.
And now for the ever popular gluteal exercise. Now this is the incorrect way to do the exercise. Jules is lifting her back off the floor, and this could cause injuries. So Jules, go ahead and put your hand over your abdomen. Your lower back is your anchor. Your abdomen helps keep your lower back on the floor. And you only need to lift your hips up off the floor slightly, but remember to squeeze those gluteal muscles like a fist. I like to sandwich the gluteal exercise between the two hamstring exercises because I think it's an effective way to work the gluteal muscles without having too much fatigue in the lower back. So with that in mind, let's hit the deck on the floor and begin the exercise. To begin with, both shoulders on the floor, knees about shoulder width apart, feet slightly in front of the knees. Now, I want you to think of your lower back being your anchor and lifting your hips away from your lower back. Let's begin the exercise up and up. Place your hand on your abdomen to accentuate that feeling of the lower back being pressed to the floor. Now that we have all that, I want you to think about the intensity. I want you to think about your gluteal muscle being like a fist and bringing the muscle up towards your lower back and at the same time wrapping the muscle from the front to back so you have the muscle contracting in all directions at all times. Up and up. Tight and tight. Now you'll get out of this exercise only what you put into it. So if you're willing to really work that muscle, to really contract, you're going to see good results. You're going to see that muscle get more defined, more toned. And that's what we're after. Check your lower back, check your shoulders, make sure everything is in its proper place. Remember that anchor. Remember your hand on your abdomen. Remember to work 100%. Get ready to change for two up. Here we go. And up, up, down. It's kind of a rolling motion, as if your tailbone is the first thing to leave the ground and the last thing to touch the ground. So you're rolling up and rolling down. Up, up, down. That up movement is not a big bouncy movement. It's more of a hold, a tightening. You know, if you tighten the lid on a jar, you tighten it in little increments, little bits at a time. That's what we're doing here. And tight, 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 tight. Now this movement is hardly seen with the eye. It's a very internal, intense movement. We're challenging the muscle. We're making it very strong. Tighten that jar. Tight, 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 tight. Okay, now in your mind's eye, I want you to picture that muscle getting shorter and shorter, more and more contracted. That's how it's working. That's how it's getting strong. Get ready to change now. Bring the knees in and out. Now push and push. It's a two-sided movement. We're pushing against gravity and with it. Push, 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 push. Picture the air being thick and that you're using that as your resistance. Create the resistance within your body. You can make the exercise that much more effective. Don't let go of those gluteal muscles. Keep them tight. Keep pulling up from the back of the leg, wrapping them around, front to back. Okay, let's make it faster. Speed up the tempo so it's touch, touch, touch. You may need to bring the feet a little closer together so you don't have to twist on the knees. Touch, touch, tap, tap. Tighten up. Okay, get ready to change. We're going to keep the knees together and just bring the body up and down with the feet apart. And up and down, up and down. It's good to work the muscle slightly differently with each of these variations. It affects the muscle dynamically. Each time we just even change slightly. So get ready for a big dynamic change. Bring the ankles together, ankles and knees press together, up and down. Now, the harder you press your ankles and knees together, the more resistance, the more challenge you're going to create for yourself. The great thing about this exercise is it will not hurt you, it will only help you, and it will help you a lot. Tight and tight. Get the knees, ankles together, no daylight between the knees. Now, I'm feeling the fatigue a lot. I'm feeling it down the back of my leg. I'm feeling it up into the gluteal muscles as it should be. Take it up for two. Here we go. And up, up, down. Up, up, down. Remember that rolling motion. You want to move from the lower back to the hip in a slow rolling motion. Okay. That felt great, right? Right. Yeah, right. Okay. Let's bring the knees to the chest and take a stretch. Very important to stretch after each exercise.
It's important to stretch after each exercise. It helps prevent injury.
Working the hamstring of the other leg, I'd like to remind you of some very important things. Vanessa, if you would. When doing the exercise, it's very important that the knee be no higher than the hip. Good. And that both hips are facing the floor equally. Then you're ready to do the exercise. Now we're ready for hamstring party number two. And let's get in the position, and I'll kind of remind you of the proper form as we get into it, because it's a constant thing we do. We keep reminding ourselves, even if we've done the exercise many times, you gotta stay on top of it. Okay, get the hips down, back level, shoulders square, in and out. In and out. Think about separating the shoulder blades, lifting your back. Again, a straight line from your head to your tailbone. Don't drop the head too much. That's not... We want to create, at all times, a good alignment. You may need to rock your body forward or backward, but make sure that the supporting knee is directly under the hip. Again, I must remind you in this exercise that I know it's a little difficult for some of you, and if you're a beginner, you want to do possibly less repetition. Up for three. And down. So it may be appropriate for you to take a stretch halfway through, or else change legs. That might be another option. But be very particular about your form. Don't ever sacrifice form for repetition. Because the endurance will come if the form is good. And then you'll have a nice long career in exercising. For two, up. The downward movement starts the upward movement. Keep it going. Continuous. You can look down, see that both hips are facing the floor equally. Create that inner resistance, create it for yourself. Now we're just going to hold it up and pulse. Point and flex, square it off. Have a sense of your knee being no higher than your hip. Sometimes it takes a little practice to really be in touch with your form, but it comes, and then you feel very much in control. A little more, up and up. Point and flex, keep that movement very small. No big bouncing movement here. From the beginning, and extend and pull. Come on, baby, come on, baby, come on, leg. Get ready for a change, now for three. Up, one, two, three, there it is. One, two, that's what keeps me coming back. That's the good times. For two. Now you notice that I don't do a lot of counting. We just kind of sing the words and have a good time. Let's hold it up and push and point. Flex, remember? That the elbows are under the shoulders, don't have the body too elongated. You want to keep everything very squared off. Last few, last two. Okay, you're there. Take a stretch.
All the exercises are presented in an order to give you the greatest